I just don't want to put Wrath in a position where he won't be able to counterattack the mage. Ooh, I forgot to put his animations on. Damn it. If I have to be attacked, we at least want to give as good as we get. If not better. So I'll move you here. Yeah, that's generally why archers are borderline useless. They have their uses, but you know. Yeah, the unfortunate thing is we can't reach the mage to, like, neutralize him on this turn, or else I would definitely do that, but knowing that I can't do that, I'd rather put units that are able to, you know, counterattack him. And if I can move Will to that, yeah, good. Wait a minute. If I can sing for Urg, 8, 3, I can double this guy. Will I kill him? Is the question. 11 minus 2 is 9. Yeah, I can actually kill this guy. So I'll go ahead and do that. Unless I moved. No, I should be able to reach him from here. Yep. Alright, good deal. Finally, Urg has a use. I mean, I could have done that with Lucius if I wanted to, but I couldn't reach Lucius. And that mage is just gonna, you know, not that mage, that archer is just gonna, you know, go and kill himself for us. You're here, and this is just, you know, just trying to keep our units out of these red squares so they can't be attacked. Alright, we weren't too long in the forest. Alright, nice. See what our real mage option is, she's gonna blow you away. You know, at least I say hoping that she isn't a disappointment, but even with having not absolutely maxed out stats, Nino is most certainly a beast. She's going to be a beast when we get her. And now we just want to move Florian away from her because this guy will come to attack her. Right, so pretty much like rain kind of cuts our movement. 2, 3. Kind of cuts it in half. So we just kind of have to do our best to, you know, deal with it. I don't know why I put these guys next to the mountain. They're not going to be able to move. That was, like, poor foresight. Yeah, nomads can move pretty well in the rain. Let's move him there. Look, the clouds are breaking. This rain should stop soon. Yeah, at this point, I'm just trying to get everybody out of the forest so that we can, like, you know, move slightly faster. I'll just leave you there. You need to be here a little bit. That's the only thing, is that this part takes forever because of the rain. See, but actually, we can lure this archer out. We'll have Lucius take care of him. Take out this shaman, no problems. And we'll send him over here. McDoubly, sure. You have a defense of 7, you have an attack of 10, so you'll do 3 damage to him if you hit him. 10. He'll do 8 damage, so he won't die, so. That's what's important here. Send him over there. Pretty much anybody else we send across is in danger of, you know, being attacked by that bow, so pretty much anyone else we send over, I'd like them to have a way to counterattack. Which Dorcas kind of can, but his terrible accuracy, I'm going to put him here. Urk, I don't really want to put Urk next to any of the forest tiles, because that'll give the archer a chance to, you know, hit him. Advantageously hit him, I should say. Put you there. Yeah, this may be a little bit of an extra step, but can't be too cautious. Everyone else will kind of stack up here for just this turn, so we can take care of that archer without too many problems. And I'm pretty sure that shaman down there has the strength ring I'm looking for. Ooh, that is so nice. That's practically a perfect level for him. Nils, I wish that you were a combat unit so we could make use of your amazing growths. I mean, they aren't amazing. He never gets strength or skill, so he's really only an avoidance machine. Like, his strength and skill, I think they cap out, like, at 15 or 5 or something ridiculous like that, but he's a very useful dodger. You can use him as a pretty good bait. You can use him as a masturbator. Alright, let's do this. Oh, nice. That's not nice, though, not being able to kill him in one turn. Would have been nice if you did that. God, I love light magic. Not as much as dark magic, but I do love it. I do love crits and the crit animations in these games. They're really good. Let's see. Well, we're gonna kinda, you know, if I hurry up and get my ass over here, we're gonna kinda use Dorcas to plug up that bridge over there, because we're gonna get a lot of those knights, those cavaliers spawning. I mean, I'll just have you take care of this guy. Ooh, we should have gotten that the previous turn. The crit animation for the Nomad Troopers is better, though, because, like, the horse kind of does, like, this. Like, he's grooving his head, like, he knows he's about to fuck some shit up. But, yeah, Nomad Troopers are actually pretty good units. I like them a lot. And Wrath is pretty much your only option for one of those. So if you don't like just straight-up archers, you might consider saving your Orion's Bolt for Wrath and just use him. He's a good unit. Like, I do like him. It's just, I have a soft spot for Rebecca for whatever reason. Ooh, I gotta get to this village, actually, before this guy destroys it. He can't destroy it this turn, but yeah, I can't dilly-dally. You finally made it here, have you? Such a long way. We're all behind Lady Lindis, all of us. Here, take this. Use it in battle against Lunchkin, please. It's an energy ring. It'll increase your strength and magic profit. Oh, okay, so this is where we got the energy. The energy ring. And, yep, that's pretty much who I'm gonna give it to. I'm gonna give it to Lynn. I mean, Sarah is also a good option. I don't know, like, Sarah has a 50% growth in magic, so the odds should be in my favor that she'll get those growths. Will she, though, is another story. And I cannot move my units to cover to this. See, what I really want to do is have them occupying these two tiles right here. Because then that would allow them to pretty much wall off this whole area from incoming enemies. And I would put Florina there, but, like, she's gonna get one-shot by that brigand. You can go down here and break that snag. You can also go over there. Pretty much, I just want to move all the units who aren't gonna help me immediately out of the way. It's kind of unavoidable. Yeah, if I move him there, he's gonna be attacked by two units. Can't move her there either. However, where can you move to, Liz? I can maybe move her on this forest tile. Let's get you out of the way. Let's see if this works out. Because whoever I move right here is gonna get attacked by two people. And I can't move to that tile after all. That sucks ass. That majorly sucks. The big one. Yeah, whoever, like, it's not a good idea for me to move anybody there, to be perfectly honest. It's not. 77. I mean, I could put Lynn there. Chances are she will dodge, at least the axe user. Now let us hope those are not famous last words. Because that really would suck. I don't want to have to start this chapter over. This chapter is kind of tedious. It's not difficult, but it is tedious. And I didn't want to heal you. Why would you do that? Very, very tedious chapter. Just for the amount of time it takes. With just one strength, she would have been able to kill that guy in one turn. Just one. That's all she needed. Okay, this is getting a little hairy. Yeah, normally I'm down here already, so... yeah... this is a little... iffy, to say the least. Like, I'm going to need a knight to go right there anyways, like, I can't leave that unplugged. So we'll have you here. This guy is going to come over here and attack at least one of our units. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. So yeah, he can go all the way over here where Matthew is because he has 7 movement points, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So he can attack pretty much this whole area right here. But if I move all this here, now he can't. I could actually take Wallace's weapons away and just, like, everything would attack him because the computer can see that there's no way of, you know, him counter-attacking them. Sorry, it came out weird.